The Strand Theater was once a beautiful building that was located in downtown Brockton. On the night of March 10, 1941, the building caught fire. The firefight was one of the deadliest of its time, claiming the lives of 13 Brockton firefighters, at first thought to be only 12. Jim Benson, a local author, worked with Nicole Casper, who is an archive specialist at Stonehill College, to bring together a book about the Strand Theater fire. Today's episode showcases the unveiling of this brand new book, as well as the annual dedication ceremony held at City Hall. You're watching One North Maine.
My name is Carl Landerholm of the Historical Society, and very, very proud to have you all sitting here and recognizing the importance of the work of Jim Benson, Nicole Casper, Kenny Galligan. He was the proofreader, and all of the good things that we have managed because of their auspices, and it helps the society, it honors the families. My father was on the fire department as a lineman in the signal group. And when the general alarm was called, he would put the floodlights, he put a floodlight down that didn't have enough extension cord where engine company one was. He had to go back out to School Street up to Main and in front of the Kennedy building where ladder two was to retrieve additional extension cord. As he came through the door, the roof came down and he was not in harm's way at that point. So it was his wish that everybody in our family commemorate tomorrow, which is March 10th. It's a very important date for a lot of people.
On behalf of the current Brockton Fire Department, I want to say thank you to Retired Chief Galligan, Jim Benson, and Nicole in the Stonehill College Archives for providing all the pictures for this book. One of the most important things that you learn when you join the Brockton Fire Department is the important history and tradition of remembering our 13 brothers that were lost in the Strand Theater fire. It's something that's instilled in you from day one. You know, there are many events throughout the year that firefighters, what I call, put on our dress uniforms for. March 10th is just about the most important of all. There are some firefighters that, because of time or what have you, only put that dress uniform on once a year. And for a lot of them, it's March 10th. And that's because it's so important to us to remember our brothers. So on behalf of today's Brockton Fire Department, I want to thank you all for being here. I hope to see you all tomorrow morning at the Remembrance at City Hall. Thank you for coming tonight. Again, thank you for supporting this book.
When you think about the Strand Theater fire, you think about how fewer and fewer people we have alive today to tell the stories firsthand of things that happened at that point in time. You know, I think about World War II vets and how few of them are left. And each year that goes by, there are fewer and fewer Brocktonians who actually remember the fire themselves. So I think it makes what you guys have done writing the book that much more important, because one of the things I really love about our city is the history. We have so much significant history to this city. And whether it's the Underground Railroad or the work of Thomas Edison and so many great things that have happened in the city, the labor union movement, the Industrial Revolution, I mean, we just have this unbelievable history. And a really, really important piece of that history, and really, I think, part of the fabric of our city, is the tragedy of the Strand Theater fire. And it's just so critically important that we remember it and continue to tell the story. So, you know, so many things in the world have changed since 1941, and I know How many things have changed with firefighting since 1941 in terms of science and equipment and technology? But then you think about some of the basics really haven't changed. It's men and women running into a burning building without regard of their own safety to save others. That hasn't changed. You know, it's saving lives. Firefighters today may save lives in some different ways than they did back in 1941, but it's still the same basics. And so I think when we think about what happened back in 1941 and the lives that were lost and those that were also injured so badly, that, you know, I think it serves to remind us about what's really important in terms of public safety and first responders and what our professional fire department does for us every day. As the mayor, I get a chance to really see it firsthand all the time. And you don't really truly appreciate it unless you have the opportunity to see them responding to life-threatening situations every day. So on behalf of the city, for the families of both victims and survivors of the fire, thank you so much for being here. I know that as a city and as our fire department, we're going to make sure that the history and the story of the Strand Theater fire continues to be passed along from generation to generation, and that the importance of the lives that were lost will never, ever diminish in the city. Thank you.
And if you could please remain standing and join me for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Present! Arms!
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Order! Arms!
Let us pray. We pause and give you thanks, O God, for those who serve you, those who protect and preserve life, those who give of themselves, even sacrificing their lives, for those entrusted to their care. We remember those who gave their lives in the night of the Strand Fire. Lord, we count it an honor to follow them in a proud legacy of duty fulfilled, and of courage, and of compassion. May we in our day, we pray, O Lord, serve you with a strength and a dedication matching theirs, as they certainly proved it so well that night. Bless their families and our fire department, bless our police department, our mayor and the city of Brockton, and all those who seek to do your will. We gather here in your holy name. Amen.
Honor God's flags down.
Thank you, Reverend. On behalf of the Brockton Fire Department and the Brockton Firefighters Union Local 144, I would like to welcome you to the 76th anniversary of the Strand Theater Fire that claimed the lives of our 13 Brockton firefighters and injured many more of the members of the fire department back on March 10, 1941. As we have for the past 75 years, we have held our ceremony inside City Hall and in front of a beautiful piece of anthracite that was presented to us by the members of the Scranton, Pennsylvania Fire Department. Today, we have members from other locals here, Melrose, Everett, Bridgewater. I want to thank them for being here. And as I said, today we continue our great tradition of honoring our fallen brothers. Since our dedication in 2008, Our brothers have continued to play games with us, as we know firefighters do. We've been able to hold this ceremony outside twice. The dedication of the memorial, and then last year at our 75th. Well, this year they turned it around on us again and they made it snow. So wherever they are, they're always playing the games on us. During the planning and reconstruction of the plaza, we were afforded a strong seat, a strong voice, and a control over what happened in our area outside. And I want to thank Mayor Carpenter, his administration, for that leeway that we had. Once again, I'd like to thank you all for being here today, especially to the family and friends of these brave men, as well as to our retired and current members of the fire department. I would also like to thank at this point the following dignitaries: Mayor Bill Carpenter, retired Fire Chief Ken Galligan, retired Fire Chief Rich Francis, current Fire Chief Mike Williams. We have Council President Bob Sullivan, Councilor Jack Lally, Shayna Barnes, Moises Rodriguez, and Wynn Farwell. And from our State House delegation, we have Representative Jerry Cassidy. Senator Mike Brady is on his way. He had another function earlier. There he is. Somehow he always pops up. And if I have missed anyone else, I'm very sorry about that. But I'd also like to reach out and thank professional firefighters of Massachusetts President Rich McKinnon and also PFFM Ledge Agent Paul Jakes for taking time out of their busy schedules to be here and join us. At this time, I would like to invite Mayor Bill Carpenter to say a few words.
Hooray! Rest!
Turn down just a little bit. Well, good morning, everyone. Let me also join Archie in welcoming everyone here to this year's Strand Theater Fire Memorial Ceremony. You know, when you think about the events as a city that we hold each year, there are a handful that just have a place above the rest of the others, and it's Memorial Day, it's 9/11, and it's the Strand Theater Fire Memorial Day. And I just truly appreciate everyone being here to participate in the ceremony this morning. Very briefly, I believe today's ceremony begins with remembering the sacrifice of those who were lost. 1941, 76 or so years ago now. There are probably not too many of us here that remember the fire, but it's just so important, not just to our fire department, but to our city, that we remember the sacrifice, the price that was paid, not just of the 13 who were lost, but the families, the 20 who were injured, many gravely, their families, and the price that was paid by the city on the night of the Strand Theater fire. I think it's also important for us to continue to learn from the memory of what happened at the Strand Theater. And, you know, at times I think about making sure that our firefighters have the best equipment, the best technology, that we're giving them everything that they need to do what they do when called upon. And our commitment to that never wavers. When I think about the Strand Theater fire, I also think about our city and the way that the efforts of all of the fires and the sacrifice of those that were lost and injured that night really represents what our city is all about. The heroism of all of the firefighters that evening. You know, I never cease to be amazed and never fail for a second to appreciate the fact that, you know, when the fire department arrives, firefighters are running in while everyone else is running out. And as much as has changed since 1941, that basic has not changed. They ran in 1941 just as they continue to run in today. And I think it also, I think about our city. You know, Brockton's a tough city, tough, resilient, and the devastating impact that that tragedy had on our city, but the way the city of Brockton bounced back, just like we always bounce back, no matter what the challenge is. And Brockton bounced back. So we recovered, but we remember at the same time. And It really brings me to a great appreciation of what the fire department and all of our first responders mean to this city today. And a day like today, we're reminded to just never take for granted what our firefighters and police officers and EMTs do for us in terms of protecting us each and every day. I have the opportunity as mayor to see it firsthand, unfortunately far too often, but I have a great appreciation for what they do for us, and I think it's important on a day like today that we take a few moments to remember that. And Archie, I do appreciate you mentioning the statue, because one thing about getting to come to work here every day is you're surrounded by the history of the city. You can't forget the history of the city. It's all through here. And you know, a day doesn't go by that I don't walk by that Strand Theater statue memorial and just be vividly reminded about what an important place that takes just outside of City Hall as part of City Hall Plaza, but also just the important reminder and beautiful reminder it gives to us every day of the events of March 10th, 1941. So it's an honor and a privilege for me to participate in the ceremony with everyone this morning. I thank you all for being here.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Thank you, Archie. Good morning. Good morning. Mayor Carpenter, elected officials, Reverend McCoy, Brockton Police and Fire Department Honor Guards, the Brockton Firefighters Pipes and Drums, department members, current and retired, families of our departed brothers and friends. I would like to thank you for joining us here this morning for this, the 76th anniversary memorial ceremony. For the 13 Brockton firefighters who lost their lives in the Strand Theater fire on March 10th, 1941. If you ask any fire chief anywhere, no matter whether they are a past or present chief, they would tell you that by far their biggest fear in holding that position is the nightmare thought of a line of duty death of even one of his firefighters. To be faced with 13, for me, is almost inconceivable. In 1941, the Brockton Fire Department was led by Chief Frank Dickinson. Certainly, I cannot speak for Chief Dickinson, nor can I imagine the amount of pain and sorrow that he and all the members of this department felt on that cold, dark day, or how he was able to pick up the pieces of what I'm sure was a shattered department, and to try and hold that department together and move forward after having lost 13 of its brave members. Or the pain of having to tell 13 families that their loved one had perished in a fire and would not be coming home. Certainly a task no any one person should ever have to endure. So as we gather once again, as we do each year on this somber date, I ask, may God continue to bless the souls of our 13 brothers lost 76 years ago today. May he continue to bless their families, and may he always watch over firefighters, police officers, and EMS personnel everywhere. Thank you.
There is one person that is no longer with us, but we recognize and remember him each and every day and every year, and that's Chief Burrell, who we have an empty seat there with his baseball cap on it. He was a great inspiration for us on the monument, and I want to thank Lieutenant Richie Baker, retired, for the efforts that he began this great endeavor. So, all right. In your prayers, I ask that you include all those serving in our armed forces, those that have given the ultimate sacrifice, those that have been injured. Also remember our brother and sister firefighters, police officers, EMS personnel, and especially remember the following 13 members that lost their lives fighting the Strand Theater fire and their families. As we honor these men, we should also take time to remember and honor all those who fought at that fire.
Oh, 10, 2, Flags. Up. Present. Arms.
We have Captain John F. Carroll, Ladder Company 3. Lieutenant Raymond A. Mitchell, Engine Company 4. Firefighter Matthew E. McGarry, Ladder Company 3. Firefighter Roy A. McCarrigan, Squad A. Firefighter Dennis P. Murphy, Squad A. Firefighter William J. Murphy, Squad A. Firefighter Daniel C. O'Brien, Squad A. Firefighter George A. Collins, Engine Company 1. Firefighter Frederick F. Kelly, Engine Company 1. Firefighter Martin E. Lipper, Engine Company 1. Firefighter Henry E. Sullivan, Engine Company 1. Firefighter John M. McNeil, Ladder Company 1. Firefighter Bartholomew Herlihy, Ladder Company 1.
Order! Arms!
At this time, if we could have a moment of silence. Thank you. I would like to take this moment to thank the honor guards from the Brockton Police Department and the Brockton Fire Department along with the Brockton firefighters' pipes and drums. Also, a special thanks to retired Fire Chief Ken Galligan and the members of the Brockton Fire Museum, who have put up a wonderful display out in the rotunda, and also at the Historical Society, and we will have some down at our Union Hall later on. I thank you very much for that. If you have not seen these displays, please take time out to go and visit them. They're wonderful pictures, and it's a great history lesson about everything.
Present! Up! Order! Up!